Okay, so one good thing about me being a little bit late doing the show is that I was able to download Kenny Loggins' Greatest Hits. And that's a good thing, right? So I'm going to listen to this Kenny Loggins song that I'm pretty sure I haven't heard in 20 years, but it was always the only Kenny Loggins song I ever liked. I always joke around about Kenny Loggins, but I don't actually like him. I mean, I know what Danger Zone is. I hear it on the radio and the song Footloose. But I don't like Kenny Loggins. But this song used to be on the radio, and I liked it. And it might suck, because, you know, you think old things are great, but then you listen to them and they're horrible. But I'm going to listen to this, and then I'm going to start a show. And we'll see if it's any good. It's probably going to be horrible, but here it goes. This is the theme from Caddyshack 2. Enough of that song. Hey everyone, it's RBCP. I'm doing a show. Like I said before, don't get your hopes up. I did get some numbers, but just a few. Actually, I tried to get U-Haul numbers, and I failed at it. It's not that I failed, it's that the U-Haul people failed. They didn't know how to pull up old accounts. But Ice Goose and Polkja, they seem to do just fine, so maybe I just suck. Because they called some U-Haul people earlier, and I don't know, those were pretty amusing, I thought. That was Kenny Loggins. That's a song I haven't heard in about 20 years. Like, it was popular on the radio 20 years ago, but then it was never, ever popular again. Like, they haven't, you know, they don't play it on the 80s station or anything, or 90s or whatever it was. That was fun to listen to. I don't think I'll ever listen to it again, but it was alright. It was okay. I guess. So the problem with doing a show this late is that I've had, like 13 Four Locos. That's like, hold on 1 second. Let me get out my calculator. That's like 52 beers. I haven't really had 13 Four Locos. I'd probably be dead if I did that. I'm not Matt Hillock, goddammit. Okay, so, I really wanted to do something different. I say this every single week. I think I've said this the past 3 or 4 weeks that I've done a show. I wanted to do something new. Ice Goose actually gave me a bunch of good ideas. He's the one that told me I should do truck rentals. So I tried U-Haul, and I tried Hertz cars, and I just couldn't get anywhere with the employees. And it's not because they didn't believe me. They believed me, but they're just stupid or something. Like, they couldn't... Well, not stupid. That's not nice. They just didn't know how to pull up the information in their computers. They were asking me, they're like, well, how do I pull up previous rentals that I've done and stuff like that? So it's not their fault. It's just, God damn it. Shut up, Carlitos. Just tell me to play something from this century. I played something from this century, like, 2 songs ago. Damn it, damn it. Damn it, here. Wait, no. There, there. There's Lily Allen. I'll just play what I play every week. That'll make you happy. Okay, so let's see. Yeah, I have like 10 numbers here. Hold on a second. Oh yeah, Cole, he had a good idea for me last week. He said I should call pet grooming businesses. You know, people that go to get their dogs washed and nails clipped and all that. And I'm pretty sure that'd be easy if I just called Petco and said, hey, read me all the stuff on your computers. I could do it. But then I couldn't think of anything I could really say to him. And I was afraid it was going to turn ugly. Like I would say something, you know, like your dog has AIDS or something. And that'd probably be a bad thing to do. I don't know. Maybe next time I do a show, I'll do Petco. Because that really, I mean, that would be so easy. And that could be funny. So, Stalin WTC is asking, where are my downloadable shows? You big dummy, they're on phonelosers.org. The latest post on phonelosers.org has the latest show from 2 weeks ago. And then there's also phonelosers.org/phone show. That's where the old phone shows are. And I don't know, there's shows all over that site. Just subscribe to the iTunes. Or just go to iTunes and type in Phone Losers of America, and you'll find a link in there to subscribe to everything. I had an amazing idea, but I'm afraid it's going to be too... I don't know why I think it would be illegal. Like, I mean, basically all this stuff is illegal, but there's some things that are more illegal than other things. And I was thinking, like, I could call the UPS store in any city and get them to give me... phone numbers of customers that had recently sent packages. And the only reason I'm worried about that is, like, I don't know, like the US mail, that's a government thing. And then there's UPS, which isn't, I don't think it's government, but maybe it is. I don't know. It just seems like a bad idea to mess with UPS for some reason. Or FedEx. I'm positive I could easily get info. And the same thing with, like, pharmacies. Pharmacies, they have very specific laws about getting medical information from pharmacies or hospitals. And even though it would be super easy to do, I'm not going to do that stuff. Because that's like, there's no gray area there. That's just illegal. I guess if you're not on the East Coast, happy 420 day. I've snorted, like, 3 marijuanas. And I'm going to inject some marijuanas later. Somebody's messaging me on Skype. Dark Stranger! She's saying stuff I don't understand. Oh, Dark Stranger's got her chat room going. Apparently there are people in it, but I don't have enough. I only have 3 windows in front of me right now. I can't handle another window of Tiny Chat. But if you want to go to Dark Stranger's Tiny Chat any time of the week, it's tinychat.com/cactusthis. And I hear hilarious things happen there all the time. But anyway, I wasn't original tonight. I had some other ideas that just didn't work out. I tried really hard. I ended up having company come over, and then that really delayed me getting info. But so I did photos instead. Photos at a photo development place.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system.
I can't handle this song anymore. It was amazing like 2 months ago, but no, not anymore. At least this Dr. Dre song I haven't heard in 10 years. So this is going to be a short show, by the way. Like, I don't have the energy to keep going much longer, but I'll get through these numbers. Oh, Dark Stranger has this hilarious idea about bookstores.
You're not available right now.
That I don't think I want to give it away, but bookstores. I really want to call bookstores and do this idea of Dark Stranger's, but I don't want to give it away, so I'm not going to talk about it right now. But if me and Stacy do a morning show, that would be a good time, because bookstores would actually be open in the mornings. But yeah, I need to write down this idea she sent me. Dark Stranger says everyone hates Jose. I don't hate you, Jose. You sent me money today, so I'm not allowed to hate you. You have a week of no hate from me. Shut up, Carlitos.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voicemail.
See, this is how tonight's gonna go. It's just nobody's gonna answer. I'm sorry, I shouldn't tell Carlitos to shut up, because he's the one hosting the stream, so he's gonna get online and just kick me off and say, fuck you, Brad. All right, take four.
Hello?
Hi, is this Veronica?
No, I'll go get her for you.
Oh, great.
Hold on a second.
So if anyone in the chat room can give me ideas of what to say to photo customers, because I sure don't know.
Hello?
Oh, hi, this doesn't sound like Veronica.
Can I help you?
Oh, is Veronica there?
Can I help you?
No, I definitely need to talk to Veronica.
That was not work at 10 o'clock at night. That's bullshit.
What's bullshit? What's bullshit, sir? You talking shit about me? Hello?
Hello?
Oh, hi. Did you tell me I'm full of bullshit?
No.
Oh, okay. I must have misunderstood.
Yeah, can I help you?
No, I just need to talk to Veronica.
Where are you? Can I take a message?
No. Should I just try back later then?
No, don't try back at all.
Why not? She's doing business with us, and it's her name that's on the order. She had some photos developed with us.
But what's the name of your company, sir?
There's not a male's name on it, so I don't think it's you. So I just need to.
What is the name of your company, sir? You represent. What's your name?
Roy.
Roy.
Yep.
And where are you from? Or
okay, I just need to talk to Veronica. Should I try back later then? Because her name's on these photos. I can't talk to somebody else about her photos.
I understand, but...
So don't be retarded.
I understand. Is your manager available?
No.
He's not. When is he or she there?
Maybe later. Maybe I should just call back later.
Later tonight? Tomorrow?
Yeah, you want to call back later? Maybe 3 a.m. or something?
What, your name is Roy what?
I didn't give you the last name.
Okay, so it's just... They'll know you as Roy?
Right. I'm the only Roy that works in the store.
Very good, sir. I'll be calling back tomorrow. What time do they get there tomorrow?
You big dummy. I don't know, like 10 o'clock in the morning, I guess.
Great. You know what time it is now?
Yeah, you retard. It's 10. Are you going to tell me you're asleep at 10? It's only 10.
You're good. Have a good night, Roy.
Hey, I want to talk to Veronica, asshole. Okay. Roy is going to get fired tomorrow.
Hello?
Hello, is Veronica there?
Is this Roy?
Yeah.
Can I take a message?
Oh, no, we got disconnected earlier somehow. I'm not sure.
Yeah, that was me.
Oh.
I disconnected you.
Oh, that's
weird. I don't
like
beaner.
You don't like what?
I'll be down there talking to your manager tomorrow when he's there or she's there.
Well, no, we can't talk to you about Veronica's pictures.
That's totally fine. You used profanity. And I'm going to file a complaint. You're calling at 10 o'clock at night.
Well, you didn't record the call, so no one's going to believe you.
And you called me retarded also?
No one's going to believe you. You're not recording the
call.
That's
fine. Have a good night, Roy.
Good luck. Okay, let me write a note here. Didn't a female answer at first? I can't remember. Maybe I imagined that. Yeah, so if anyone has any good ideas of what I could say to photo customers, these are people that brought their photos into or they ordered prints through the internet. There's one lady here that actually ordered, she actually still uses 35mm film. She got a bunch of pictures done on 35mm film. Two rolls. She's the only one, though. Actually, no, I think there's two. This one says exposures. Exposures would mean film, right? 25 APS megs. I don't know what any of that means. So the weirdest thing happened to me, just like right before I started the show, I went downstairs to get another Four Loko, and I turned on the kitchen light, and our hamster cage is there on a shelf on the wall, and the hamster was outside of the cage, just kind of hanging out on the shelf on top of a bag of cotton, and apparently the hamster can squeeze through these little bars of the cage. I don't understand how, but... unless he opened the cage, the latch, and got out and then shut the latch, which I don't think that's possible. But we've been noticing the hamster keeps having cotton in his cage when we don't give it to him. Like, to make a nest with or whatever. My daughter keeps noticing this. And we just thought she was, like reaching through with her mouth through the bars because the cotton's right next to the cage. But no, the hamster was outside of the cage. On top of this bag of cotton, getting some out, and then I guess was going to go back into the cage. And that's the scary thing, Dark Stranger. We have a cat. So the cat, if the cat comes in the kitchen while this hamster is outside of the cage, it's going to get eaten. And that's going to be kind of sad. So I'm a little freaked out about that right now. I feel like I should go down and check, because they're both downstairs right now. The other night, the cat knocked the entire cage off of the shelf. I wonder if it's because it saw the hamster outside of the cage. Yeah, Dark Stranger, be careful she doesn't choke. That's why we're not giving her the cotton, because we read that cotton can make hamsters choke. So we stopped giving it to her, and in retaliation, the hamster is sneaking out of the cage, and getting into the bag, and then sneaking back into the cage, and hiding the cotton underneath the rest of the stuff in the cage, like we're not going to notice. Carlita says it's like flowers for Algernon. I know what that story is, but I don't remember what specific incident he is referencing. I should read that again. That was a cool story. I think I read a dumbed-down version of it in grade school. Yeah, I should go check that soon. I left the kitchen light on too. Oh, I grabbed a giant handful of cotton and threw it in the cage. I was hoping that would just keep her in the cage for the night until we figured things out tomorrow. And I left the kitchen light on, hoping that'll make the hamster not try and sneak out all night. What should I say to these photo people, you guys?
Hello?
Hello, is Marie around?
Can I ask who's calling?
Oh, I'm calling from... she had some photos done with us earlier today.
Oh, one moment.
Okay.
Hello?
Hi, is this Marie?
Yes.
Oh, hi, I'm calling from... You had your photos done here?
Uh-huh.
And, yes. We were looking on the security cameras, because we had a lot of stuff disappear today from shoplifters. And we saw that, like, after you dropped off your pictures, you stole a bunch of DVDs. And we just, I don't know, I guess we really need you to bring those back. Like, even if you've opened them already, if you could bring those DVDs back.
I never came in to work at all today.
Oh, God damn it, then my joke doesn't work, does it?
No.
I fucked it all up. That you ordered by internet?
Yes.
It looks like on your internet pictures here that you sent in, these are all bestiality. We can't have that here. We can't develop these. I'm sorry.
Hi.
Hi.
So, really, who is this that's calling from a Skype number?
My name's Roy. I'm calling from... I can't talk to you about Marie's order, though.
Okay. Marie's going to tell you to never call this house again. And if you're from That's what you'll do.
Okay. Okay, well, let me talk to her.
You're also going to tell her which store you're calling from.
Okay,
all right. And you're going to do it on speakerphone.
No, because then I'd be talking to you, and that's crazy.
Well, if you're talking to Marie about her pictures and she's on speaker now, then that should be fine.
Okay, whatever.
I'm here.
You should have just not told me, and then I wouldn't know.
Roy, let's be real. You're not from... Or if you are, you're definitely calling not on official business.
Okay, I have a crush on her. I see her in here occasionally, and I just wanted to know if she would marry me.
Roy.
But I didn't know she was taken. I didn't know you lived with her. So, I mean,
I'll never call again.
You can't blame me for that. And he's gone. I think I'm going to delete that one. He knows too much. He knows I'm calling from Skype. What do you want, Cole? Oh, Cole mentioned, I don't remember this, but he claims he did, that I should get numbers from weight loss programs, like Weight Watchers or Jenny Craig. And I bet you that'd be pretty easy. Marie will be mine. She will be mine. Yeah, and I was thinking, like a few months ago, that I should get phone numbers of people, and I tried this and I didn't have much luck, but, like for embarrassing products, like, hair loss or, penis enlargement. I think I called, I can't remember the name. I called one of those hair loss places and I tried to get, you know, their toll-free number, and I tried to get numbers from them. And the guy immediately was suspicious of me. And he's like, are you trying to get credit cards from us? And I'm like, no. I'm just need the phone numbers is all. You know, I said this at the corporate office. Oh, no. Oh, that's not really Bookapoo. Fucking Bookapoo. Oh, and then tonight. Okay, this is the weirdest thing. Like, something I've wanted to do for a long time. I really want to call a national flowers ordering toll-free number, and I'm not going to say which one I called tonight, but I swear this happened. I'm not making this up. I called and I'm like, hey, this is blah blah corporate office and your computer's all broken. And before I could even ask him for anything, he's like, just a minute, let me transfer you. And he transferred me, and guess who he transferred me to? He transferred me to the non-emergency of the Los Angeles Police Department. That happened tonight. And that was pretty weird. And I thought about just staying on the line with the Los Angeles Police Department and asking them, like, you know, what number am I calling from? I'm from tech support, just to get that guy's home phone number or wherever he transferred me from, call center or whatever. But that was bizarre. I got transferred to the LA Police Department tonight. Damn it. I also got busted. Oh, another amazing idea I had. Staples, they have the rewards program, and sometimes when I'm at Staples, you know, the people that are in front of me in line, they're like, what's your phone number so I can put you in the rewards system, and they give out their phone numbers. And one day I wrote down the guy's phone number, some old man, and I called him and I'm like, hey, you know, you were in the store earlier today, you brought some printer ink, and we saw that on the security cameras you stole a laptop computer display. And he didn't get super mad or anything, but yeah, that's the only time I did that. I've had lots of opportunities because I go to Staples quite a bit, but I think it's a bad idea to prank locally. I don't need, you know, local police showing up here to yell at me, arrest me or whatever. Another place that I always hear a lot of numbers at, and I hate to admit that I go here, because I know you people are going to, like, call them up and get my info. No, I'm not even going to say it. But, yeah, it's another place that I'm at, and people just, you can just hang out in there and hear them say their phone numbers all day. Like, as long as you can just keep hanging out in there, as long as you possibly can, you will hear nonstop telephone numbers. And then you could call and mess with them. And I'm always tempted to, but I never do because it's a local business. Don't prank locally. Especially if you're me.
Is the Verizon ringback tone while your party is reached.
Okay, this lady was in the store, or this person.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system.
Randy.
Is not.
Randy? I didn't have the first name. It just says R. I'm going to try again.
Rise and ring back to
what's that? What's that song that's playing? I think it was Metallica. This one's different, though.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system.
Weird. He has, like, cycling songs. They change every time. Let's call. Let's see how many times it takes to get back to Metallica.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system.
I think it's doing less and less rings each time, so he's hitting the button to make the phone stop ringing. Which is weird. He's in the West Coast. He should be awake. Nobody in the chat room has told me what I should do yet to these photo customers.
Hello.
Oh, hi. Is this Randy?
Yes.
Oh, I'm calling. You brought in some photos today at our kiosk.
I'm sorry?
You brought in some photos today at our kiosk?
Oh, yeah.
Duh.
Okay.
Well, okay. Well, yeah, no, like, you wouldn't answer your phone before, trying to avoid us, because we saw on the security camera that you shoplifted from our store. But we know who you are, because didn't you use the kiosk right afterwards? So we need you to bring back the merchandise.
What did you shoplift?
Is someone else yelling?
I don't shoplift, man.
Well, of course you're going to say you don't shoplift. You're going to say you don't shoplift because, you know, you're busted. But we need you to bring back the merchandise. You stole a bunch of batteries and stuff from us.
No, I didn't.
Who the fuck is that? Can you take me off speaker?
No, I can't. I'm driving. Well, and I don't appreciate the language.
Can you tell her to shut up? Because I'm trying to talk to you. You're the only one that's on this photo order here.
And who are you?
My name's Roy, again.
Are you a manager?
No, I just work here in the photo department. But me and the security guy here just reviewed the tape, and we see that you stole from us, and we need you to bring back the merchandise you shoplifted. Because that's a crime.
I did not shoplift.
Look, I'll be honest with you. We can't do anything about it because we didn't catch you in the act. And you're gone, and you have the merchandise, but we'd really appreciate it if you could just bring it back. So you're not going to be in any trouble. We just need you to bring back the batteries and...
I don't have your merchandise. I didn't shoplift anything.
Then why do we see you on camera stealing things and then going right over to the kiosk and doing your pictures? And it says right here, it's Randy.
The pictures that I got were for a passport photo.
Okay. So that makes it okay to shoplift?
I was with the lady that does the photos.
Okay,
listen. I was with her pretty much the entire time.
Right, but before you did the photos, you weren't with anyone, and after, you weren't with anyone. But listen, I need to ask...
You never left the counter.
Okay, listen, ma'am, I need to know how big your pussy lips are.
You're done.
I'm done? What do you mean I'm done? All right, Dick Soup in the chat room, you just ruined my call, making me say that. So thanks a lot, you big jerk. Let's try again.
Is the Verizon ringback tone while your party is reached.
I don't feel bad for this guy, because listen to the music he...
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system.
Randy.
Is not available. At the tone, please record your message. When you've finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options. To send a fax, press 4 now. To leave a callback number, press 5.
I'm not going to leave a message. I wish it was easy to hack cell phone voicemails. All right. Let's take a quick break here. I'm going to go check on my hamster and make sure the hamster's not being eaten alive right now. Let's play some gay music while I'm gone. All right, I'm back. Nothing bad's happening with the cat or the hamster. Oh, one of the other things I did today, when I was trying to get numbers, I was calling all kinds of places just trying to get numbers, and I was just failing everywhere. And, wow, Mr. Clay knows this is Justin Bieber. How do you know that, Mr. Clay? Does it say it on the website? This is a Justin Bieber clip that we played on the phone show like 3 years ago. It is a song that I don't know. It's called You Smile. But this is the song slowed down 800 times, which makes it sound kind of bizarre. It makes it 35 minutes long. But you know what? If I liked a Justin Bieber song, I would not have a problem playing it on this show, because I don't care. I don't care what you guys think of me. Anyway, what I was trying to say earlier is I called a Target, and I called their photo department, and I got one phone number from them. And then the guy got suspicious. He's like, wait a minute, should I be giving out phone numbers? And he talked to somebody else, and the other guy said, well, it could be a prank call, because I could hear him in the background. And then he told me, he's like, oh, I can't give you customers' phone numbers. I'm like, oh, you can't give me that customer's phone number that you just gave me a second ago? And he's like, oh, well, I messed up on that phone number, and I didn't really give you the right one. And for some reason, I don't really believe him. I think he could be lying. But he could have also, called her and warned her. But I'm going to do the same shoplifting shtick to her and see how that works. Yep, I'm a believer. You didn't like Air Supply, so you're going to get to listen to Justin Bieber instead. You know the last Justin Bieber song that was out? I didn't think it was horrible. The one they were playing on the radio a lot, like 3 or 4 months ago.
You have reached...
Because his voice changed finally, and now he has like a different sound, and he doesn't sound like a little girl. And it's actually not that bad anymore. It's kind of Justin Timberlake sounding. I can't even remember the name of the song. I remember it wasn't that bad, though. I didn't like it enough to download it, but I didn't hate it when it came on the radio. I'm just calling this Target girl over and over and over. They probably warned her and told her not to answer her phone all night.
You have reached the Sprint voicemail box of 541.
Yeah. She's in my area code, so I should probably just quit. Cool, Rob. I listen to the FM radio in the car because my car stereo keeps getting stolen 2 times since I lived in this town. Crackheads break my window and steal my car stereo. So, no car stereo for me. No nice car stereo. I just have the factory CD player FM radio in there. So it's not my fault that I listen to FM radio. I have to.
You have reached.
Keep stealing it. Okay, one more time for this lady. I don't mind FM radio, though. I like top 40 overall. I mean, it's like tons of commercials, but aside from the commercials, you just have to flip around until you actually hear music on the FM.
Hello?
Hi, Ashley.
No, you got the wrong number, sorry.
No, this is Ashley Reed. Don't lie. You had pictures.
I'm sorry. It's...
It is what? So. You had your pictures done at Target, right?
No.
Oh, balls.
No.
Balls.
No.
Balls.
Excuse.
Balls. I'm sorry. I was trying to reach Ashley, and I guess they put the wrong number on here.
Yeah, well, you've got the wrong number. Thank you.
Balls. 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 I know you're Ashley. Okay, she's gone. All right, maybe Target, the guy didn't lie to me. He really did give me the wrong phone number, apparently. Damn it. Damn it, damn it, damn it. Yeah, Cool Rob, I actually downgraded my factory stereo. I bought one on eBay. It was a CD player, FM radio thing, just the factory thing that's garbage and nobody would steal. But I downgraded from the CD player to the cassette player, so that way I can put those cassette adapters in and play my iPod through it. But I don't know, that's a pain in the ass to attach the iPod every time you get in the car. I miss having Sirius, and I miss having the in the last thing I had, it had the USB. You know, I kept a USB stick in the glove compartment full of my crappy music. And that's gone because the crackheads stole it. I don't think she was warned, Walmart. I think he really did give me the wrong phone number. Maybe he was suspicious before I thought he was suspicious. He gave me a phone number, though. That's weird. Why'd he give me one? So I just listen to FM in the car. It's all right. I don't drive that much. If I go on long trips, then I put on podcasts. All right. All these people are females. All these picture photo people. The 35 millimeter people. I need to call her. And you people in chat room have given me no ideas. I want ideas. What should I say to photo people? What should I say to a lady that still gets 35 millimeter film developed? Weeping Angel says satellite radio sounds like shit. No, it doesn't. It sounds like radio. It's perfect, and there's no commercials. I miss satellite radio. I'm just too much of a cheapskate to pay $12 a month for it. And also, my satellite radio receiver was stolen, so I don't have satellite radio anymore. Walmart from the chat room, he says I should tell them they have a nip slip. That's a good idea. Ask how many fingers they take. Dick Soup is apparently really horny tonight. Cool Rob says I should tell them their pictures are copyrighted. I'm not sure what he means by that, but that could be funny to tell them that they're, I need them to have the copyright owner contact me. And they'll be like, there is no copyright owner. It'll be like my constant arguments with YouTube. I swear, YouTube, this music is fine to use. It's independent music. They're like, no, you need to have the owner of the music send us a letter. Snap a picture of it. Okay, all right. Someone said something funny. I mean, these are all good ideas. I especially like the Jesus one. By Bedentron.
Hello.
Oh, hi. Is this Karen?
Yes, it is.
Oh, hi. You brought in some 35 millimeter film today to have developed the two.
Yes, I got it developed. It was fine.
Okay, but it's just like the film itself, the 35 millimeter rolls, like we put them under the light and everything, and a picture of Jesus appeared on them, like the shape of Jesus on one, and then the Virgin Mary on the other.
No, all I saw was my cat.
Yeah, I mean, it looked fine on the photos that we gave you, but there's a picture of Jesus. The outline, the silhouette of Jesus, and then the silhouette of
the last cat picture of Kit had
Jesus
red on it.
Oh, that might have been like a
dye.
I'm sorry?
A red dye on it.
Oh, yeah. That could have been like a remnant of the silhouette of Jesus.
Yeah, well,
I
didn't see it, so.
I mean, are you a religious person? Do you know where these were taken?
No, I'm not. I'm not a religious person.
Well, I mean, it's definitely, without a doubt, I mean, this is the shape of Jesus. They should have shown you the 35mm film. Like, we don't get a lot of these.
No, I have the film in the thing with the CD.
Well, yeah. Well, I mean, you have the negatives, but, like, we have the roll still, and if you look at the roll and hold it up to light, there's Jesus on one, and then there's the Virgin Mary on the other.
Oh.
And then when you pull it kind of, like, out of the roll, it drips blood.
Oh. Well, that's what must have been that red stuff that was on there.
Oh, it must have been. The red dye stuff?
Because there was red stuff on the last picture of the kit.
Oh, well, that might have been our fault, because I think we dripped the blood of our Lord Savior Jesus Christ onto your picture.
Oh, well, I don't know about that, but anyway, the cat, the one picture of the cat, so these are my little feral kittens I saved. So.
Oh, I see. That's nice of you.
Yeah.
Well, do you want these physical rolls back? Because, I mean, I think they're like religious relics at this point. And I mean, they're probably.
Well, you can have them. You can have them. All I want is my cat picture. So, you know.
But our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, is on this, and the Virgin Mary.
My cats matter more to me than that.
No, nothing's more important than Jesus, ma'am. I think you're mistaken.
No, to me at this point, my cat's the most important thing in
my
life.
Well, I mean, when you die and you go before the pearly gates, are you going to tell them that your cats are more important than Jesus? What do you think they're going to say to you?
I don't believe in that. When I die, that's it. My spirit goes into the air and that's it.
You're going to go to hell. I mean, you're not even going to go before the pearly gates. You're going to go straight to hell with that kind of an attitude.
Well, that's probably true, but, you know, it's like anything else. I'll be with my cat.
Okay, well, forget religion. These are probably worth money. I mean, you've heard about people putting on eBay things that have the image of Jesus Christ.
Well, if you want to put those on eBay and sell them, go ahead.
Well, I wouldn't do that because I'm not an atheist destined
for
hell like you are.
Well, you know, if I'm going to hell, that's fine. I'll be there with a lot of people.
You're a sick woman. You need to be saved.
Well,
next time you come in this store, I'm going to pray for you. I'm going to pray for you all night tonight.
Well, good. Thank you. I appreciate that. And you can enjoy the pictures.
Okay, listen, ma'am, I need to know how many fingers can your cat take?
What do you mean?
Up its vagina.
I'm sorry. We don't talk about things like that.
Why not? You're not a Christian. You may as well. How many fingers can your...
I'm not the whore of Babylon either, buddy.
Oh, listen to you. I want to know.
I don't call people in the middle of the night and say that there's strange pictures on your camera film.
Well, I'm not making it up. I mean, have you ever fisted your cat?
I don't do things like that, sir. And I don't want you calling here anymore. I'll call the police department and turn you in.
How many fingers have you gotten in your cat's vagina?
I don't put my fingers in the cat's vagina, and I don't think anybody else should either.
Me either, but I mean, I'm religious, and you're not.
Well, good for you. That's your right as an American citizen to believe how you want. That's what the Constitution says.
I can tell by your
freedom
attitude.
Freedom of religion. Got it?
Right. And the Constitution doesn't say anything.
I don't want you calling here anymore. If you call here anymore, I will contact Citrus Heights Police Department.
The Constitution doesn't say you're allowed to fist your cat, though. That's disgusting, ma'am. All right, let me make a note here. Cat fisting. Oh crap, I think she was still on. And I'm making a note of the time and where I need to take out where she kept saying the name of the city, damn it. So that was, of course, oh, what's his name? Dick Soup. He's wanting me to ask about fisting the cat. That was amusing. She's going to have so many stories to tell her friends and her family and stuff now. You won't believe what this Walgreens employee said to me. It's disgusting. Oh, the dark stranger.
Please leave your message for 91.
Jose wants to know where he can get free.
Hi, this is Robin, but I think
audio
the phone
cable, virtual audio cable. I don't know. Go to a torrent. Go to kat.ph. I think that's what it is, or the Pirate Bay. Type in virtual audio cable, and it'll probably be on there. But I definitely don't have it because I tried to use it last night, and it kept doing that thing that it does, letting everyone know that I'm a noob. Thanks for bringing that up. Where in Google? KAT.PH or whatever kick-ass torrents is on. I'm going to keep trying this Robin lady. Because I only have 4 numbers left. So I'm just going to make it ring over and over and over until Robin picks up. Jose.
Hi, this is Robin, but I can't get to the phone right now. Leave a message.
Jose was funny last night on Friday Nights by the Fire with Polkja and Ice Goose and whoever else does that, G-Ad. They did those things, casting calls, where they put up Craigslist ads, people that want to be actors, and they get them to do anything that they want. And it was amazing. They were getting people to make prank calls for them and to, like, you know, scream lines from movies and stuff. Not from movies, but scream hilarious things like stuff about cactuses and Roy and all that. It wasn't as amazing as the prior week. The prior week was just surreal. It was just bizarre, amazing stuff. And Milkman is apparently the only person that has a copy of last week's show, Friday Nights by the Fire. And he really needs to give that to them because I want to hear that again. That was worth hearing again. Funny, funny stuff. But last night was funny, too. I mean, I'm not trying to say last night wasn't funny. Just the week before was a lot. The week before was just special. It was crazy stuff. Gotta hear last week's Friday Nights by the Fire. Apparently, last night's show is up on SoundCloud. You can download it already. But the week before, they don't have it yet. Because they're noobs and they don't record their own shows. Stupid noobs. Polkja claims she wasn't there.
Hi, this is Robin, but I can't get to the phone right now. Leave a message.
Let me try one more time. Cool Rob says. I don't know what he's talking about, because Polkja was there last night. I think last night Jose played the part of another actor that was in competition with the other actor, the potential actor that was on the phone, the victim.
Hi, this is Robin.
Okay, fine. Robin. Let's try another one. I only have 2 left. And then I'm going to have to quit the show. If I'd gone on earlier, I was going to call and do some more cakes. But I think it's too late for that. Sloth wants to know how many fingers Batman can get into Robin. Oh yeah, and I was on the show last night. I was a director. I don't think I was very awesome, but I got to yell at someone for a while, and that was fun.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system.
Nobody's answering.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system.
One more try, and then I only have one left. But I want to make it. I'm going to try some of the other ones that didn't answer before. So far, my favorite call is the religious lady call. The atheist lady call.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice.
So I've already forgotten who gave me that idea, but thank you for that. That was great.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system.
Okay, people in the chat room, tell me what I should say to this person. They didn't come in the store. They ordered 50 prints from the internet, and they haven't come in and picked them up yet, I don't think. So, what should I say to them? I don't want to say bestiality. We've done that a billion times. I don't want to say kitty porn. That ends up making them call the cops or something. Okay, last one. This could be a male. His name's Curran, or her name is Curran. It's a weird name. I probably spelled it wrong.
Hello?
Oh, hi, is this Curran?
I'm sorry, who are you, what do you know his last name?
Bentley?
That's my brother.
Oh, great. Yeah, I'll talk to him then.
He's actually not here right now. This is my personal cell phone.
Oh, well, he left your personal cell phone on his pictures that he had developed here? He had 50...
At Walgreens?
Yeah, he had 50 pictures sent in through the internet.
He shouldn't... I'm confused.
Yeah, he definitely gave your number. I don't know why he'd give your number. That's weird.
Because I ordered 50 pictures that I had canceled it last night because I had to get the release form from the photographer, and I ended up getting that this morning and went in and I reordered it online and went in and picked them up.
Yeah, they were picked up. But there was a lot of nip slips on it. There were a couple nip slips. And we can't be developing stuff like that because that's pornography.
What?
The nip slips. I don't know if you looked through the pictures yet, but there were a couple of nip slips in there.
No, not these pictures. These were pictures of my daughter and my family.
Yeah.
And my dog.
Yeah, they were underage. We can't have nip slips of underage people with the dog.
I'm so confused. What do you mean?
Nip slips. Like we're not allowed to
no
develop.
I have no idea what that is.
We're not available. Nipple. You know, wardrobe malfunctions.
Oh, those pictures were not us.
Oh, well, who was that then? I mean, even if they're not you, we can't have you developing pictures of other people that have nip slips.
I never.
I mean, who were these? Who were these people if they weren't you?
Well, Brian's my brother, but I didn't know that he was developing pictures underneath my name.
Oh, yeah. I mean, maybe it was to avoid detection by us. You know, he didn't want to get in trouble for it.
I mean, I can call him and ask him, but...
I could put him on three-way if you have his number. I could put him on three-way if you have his number to find...
Hold on.
Okay.
Hold on a second.
Okay.
16.
Uh-huh. Nobody in the chat room write this down, by the way. I'm sorry, what? 7 and then what?
Hold on.
Not allowed to write this down.
Sorry, I had to just deny a call from my husband.
Oh.
52.
Everyone quit writing that down. Okay, and this is Brian then? Okay, yeah, we'll get to the bottom of this real quick because we can't do nip slips. I mean, it's just because it's a family store and all that.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe he's not going to answer because he knows. He knows we're on to him.
Hi, this is Brian. Sorry, Mr. Call.
It's late, and he has a brand new baby, too, so...
Oh. Was that who had the nip slip on it?
It could have been his girlfriend.
Oh. Did you see the pictures then, or did you not even see him? Did he just...
There's a few pictures that we took when the baby was born.
Uh-huh.
Hello?
Hello?
Hey, Christine.
Hi.
This is Connie. Hey, so did you or Brian go to and try and develop some pictures today?
No.
Huh.
Not at all.
Because I went today and I got my pictures, and they were the pictures that we had taken on the 5th, and they're actually on the line with us right now, and they said that Brian was trying to gave them my number to call, and that some of the pictures were nip slips.
Hold on, here. I'll give you Brian.
Hello?
Did you try and develop some pictures at... Hey, it's Connie. Hold Did on. You try and develop some pictures at today?
No, why?
Because is actually on the line with us right now, and they're saying that you gave them my number and were trying to develop pictures, and some of them were nip slips.
No, I haven't developed any pictures for a few years.
Huh.
Ma'am, can you shut that kid the fuck up?
What?
Can you shut the kid the fuck up? I can't hear. I can't hear Brian the pervert if the kid's crying.
He's not a pervert. He just told you that he didn't do it.
I didn't say the kid was a pervert. But I mean, can you shut the kid the fuck up?
Can you be appropriate, please?
Okay.
I'm not using language with you.
Well, I mean, at least I'm not developing, you know, nip slips of underage.
Either. It's obvious that someone else is using my brother's name.
I haven't developed any pictures in like 4 years, man.
No, we see him on the security cameras. I'm pretty sure Brian's a pervert.
Okay, then we can come in tomorrow and look at the security cameras, because I am pretty sure my brother would not be doing this.
We have VHS security tapes. We also saw him steal some batteries on the way out.
Do you even know what my brother looks like?
Yeah, I can see him on his cell phone right now. We have video chat. FaceTime.
Are you serious?
Yeah, we can see everything. And, I mean, it's totally him. I'm positive. And, yeah, he stole batteries from us earlier today.
Okay, well, I would still like to come in tomorrow with my brother and look at these security tapes.
We're going to have to, I mean, have him arrested for shoplifting and being a pervert.
I haven't even left the house at all today, so what are you talking about?
Well, of course you're going to say that. You're going to deny it and pretend that it wasn't you.
He was home with his kids.
Was that your kid being of fucking Brad, or was that Brian's?
He's 11 weeks old.
Ah, he's annoying. I mean, imagine what he's going to be like, a month from now. You need to start disciplining that brat.
She is 11 weeks old. She doesn't understand.
I mean, hit her.
No! She is 11 weeks old.
Connie,
she doesn't understand.
Connie, hang up.
Honey, what is this, incest? You guys are like an item or something? That's disgusting.
Hang up.
Bye.
They're both gone. Oh, no. Honey, hang up. Who calls their sister honey? Is that normal, or am I just weird? I'm confused. Okay, I need a break.
Looking out for love in the night so still. Oh, how dear. How
So instead of calling them back right now, I'm gonna hold on to both of their numbers. They're on a conference call. And I'm going to call them a little bit later, and hopefully they'll both pick up at the same time, and they'll think that each other called each other. Maybe. Hopefully. I don't know. We'll see.
Hello?
Oh, hello?
Hello?
Oh, hi, I'm sorry. Is this Angelina? I may as well just say the address at this point, because I got to edit now. You had your photos done here earlier?
Yeah.
Okay, and, you know, we checked the security cameras after you left, and we saw that you shoplifted batteries and tampons. So.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we definitely need you to bring back that stuff that you shoplifted after you got your pictures.
So I have to bring, maybe tomorrow I can stop by.
Yeah, I mean, you understand that's illegal, right? You're not allowed to shoplift. You can't steal from...
Oh, because the lady, she helped me.
Oh,
to do that.
She said you could shoplift?
The lady for the pictures.
Oh, really?
Did she was telling me because I didn't know how to use the machine.
Oh, really? Did she say, oh, since you're foreign and you don't understand, you're allowed to shoplift tampons and batteries?
Okay, but I can be there if you want.
Can you come right now and bring back the stuff you stole from us? You stole merchandise. You stole from our store.
No.
Yeah. Yeah, we show here on the security cameras.
What'd I get?
Oh, you stole tampons, and you stole batteries, and you stole beer. And you stole a DVD of Ernest Saves Christmas on DVD.
No, I'm just stopping by, and I'm just doing, like, some pictures, and that's it.
And then also, after all that, you stole Kenny Loggins' Greatest Hits on CD.
I can stop by tomorrow.
And you stole some Valentine's Day candy that was on the clearance aisle on it was on clearance.
No, maybe you,
And you stole some adult diapers?
Nope.
And then you went into the toy aisle, and then you stole some plastic army men and an army tank. And you stole the board game for the office. Then you went over to the makeup aisle. You stole eyeshadow. And you stole lipstick. You stole Fuck Me Red lipstick.
And, no, I didn't stop by.
Okay, and then after that... you went behind the counter, and you got underneath the cash register, and you stole a crate of cigarettes. And when you were out in the parking lot, we have cameras out there, too. And you stole the sign that says Walgreens. You put that in your trunk.
Definitely was not me.
Okay. We need the tampons that were used and the ones that you didn't use. And it looks like you stole a full-size cutout of Captain Kirk. He's selling Expedia online.
Yeah, because I need to, like, somebody to help me, you know, like, to go, because I don't understand everything what you told me right now. But
oh.
I can be there tomorrow, because, you know, maybe something is confused, and I don't do that.
Yeah,
definitely.
We saw it on the cameras. I'm calling from security. Yeah. We saw that you went into aisle 5, and you took a big dump in the aisle, and then you stole a Jackie Chan movie. You're a bad lady, and you're going to hell. And oh, and maybe, it looks like, oh, here, I'm scrolling through the security tape. You stole some laxatives and a big wheel.
Okay, let me ask my sister. Maybe she wants to take me over there right now, and maybe I can stop by.
And then you went into the pharmacy area and you stole extra large condoms. And I'm waiting for the chat room to say more things.
Okay, let me go with my sister, and maybe she can take me right now over there, and we can see. It was not me.
Oh, okay, look, yeah, let's... Okay. Wait, where...
I want to make very clear everything, just this thing, and I want to make clear, you know?
While you were stealing the crate of cigarettes from behind the register, it looks like the cashier showed up, and she confronted you, but then to get out of trouble, you had sex with the cashier.
Okay. Okay, so... Thank you, and I will be there.
Oh, it looks like you went into the back room after, and there was a semi-truck at the loading dock delivering a shipment, and you got into the truck, and you drove off with an entire shipment from the entire Southern California Walgreens deliveries, and you took everything. And... shopping carts and a payphone. And then you raped a cactus. So you don't deny this?
Yeah, I deny everything.
We're showing that you used a red box on the payphone outside of the store.
No. I never used that.
You didn't use a red box to make illegal telephone calls?
No.
To Mexico?
No.
Then you turned the tractor trailer around, and you drove it through the store. And then you reached your hand out the window of the semi truck and stole all of the suppositories, and intended to induce anal vomiting. And then you set off. You set off the sprinklers. And then you went across the street. And you robbed the bank. And then you stole my heart. And then the people that came in with you, they went out into the parking lot and they stole a bunch of cars that belonged to customers. And you ran over a cardboard cutout of Mitt Romney and Obama. Or as Jolanta would say, Romney. And then you murdered you. Oh, she's gone. Damn it. I guess I'll delete her since she can't even understand English. That was fun. Yes, Sloth, Walgreens sells hamsters. You didn't know that? And Dick Soup, of course, he wants me to ask her how big the pussy lips are. Of course. And then your people stole all of our country's jobs. That's from Vedentron. And then she snorted 3 marijuana cigarettes. Okay, I need to stop because she hung up. It's not funny anymore, you guys. Come on, guys. All right, the next one is another one that didn't answer from the beginning of the list. Her name is Sarah, and it's an internet order. She has not picked it up yet. She ordered it through the internet. What can I say to her? Hey, Carlito. I can't believe you're still around. All right, somebody tell me, quick, what do I say to this internet girl? I mean, she's probably not going to answer. She's another no answer. I wonder if that lady's really going to come back to Walgreens. I swear I didn't drive a truck through your store.
We are not available right now. Please leave a message after the beep.
Let's try her again. So are any of you people in the chat room, are you from YouTube? Because I noticed there's a lot of people in here I don't recognize. And I begged everyone from YouTube to come in earlier, and then I was late. So are you YouTube people still here? I know Walmart's from YouTube. I think Walmart's from YouTube.
We are not available right now. Please leave a message.
Maybe I'm wrong about Walmart. All right, I'm going to try two more times to this Sarah lady. Okay, Walmart's not from YouTube. I'm dumb.
We are not available right now.
All right, one more time. Dr. Chaotic says he's from YouTube. He's probably lying, though. Hello?
Hello?
Oh, hi, is this Sarah?
Yes, who is this?
Oh, I'm calling from Walgreens. You had some photos done through the internet.
Oh, okay, okay. It's kind of late to call.
yeah, I'm not too good with the internet. I don't know. Can you just come in here and use our kiosk? Because I don't know how to... I don't have internet at my house. These things that come through the internet...
Why are you calling from your house if you're working at Walgreens?
No, I'm just saying as an example, I don't use internet from my home, but I don't know, can you just bring it in and do it on the kiosk? You know, bring in your little camera memory card thing, your compact flash card, that's what the kids use these days, right? And that would be a lot easier for me if you could just do that, because I don't understand the internet, I don't know how to use the internet. Hello? What the fuck? Sarah, come on. Hang up on me. Vedantron says to tell her she's pretty. But how would I know that? She's from the internet. I don't understand how the internet works. Hi, Sarah. We got disconnected somehow.
Yes, look, buddy, I don't know who you are, but don't call here again, you got it?
Well, no, she had some pictures sent to us through the internet.
You're not calling from a 916 number, asshole. Bye.
Yeah, guess how the phone system works, you retard. God damn this... it probably says Skype on their caller ID. Damn it. Don't they understand area codes? I guess I shouldn't talk because I don't understand the internet.
We are not available right now. Please leave a message after the beep.
Hey, Sarah. It's me again. Listen, I looked at your pictures and I think you're really pretty. And I don't know, I think, like, really, maybe you could be a model. If you're interested. And if that asshole that, you know, if you can maybe contact me without him around. He's a fucking asshole. I don't like that guy that answered the phone earlier. But, yeah, like, you know, let's get together. Maybe tomorrow, if you're not too busy, we could get together for some lunch and we could discuss, you know, your modeling career. 'Cause I have some connections in the modeling industry. And yeah, just give me a call back. And I'll talk to you tomorrow. All right. Bye, Sarah. Talk to you later. All right. I guess I will take that one off my list. I'm going to call the next one on the list that didn't pick up earlier. Her name is Lisa. Pretty much every single person on here tonight is a female. Real men don't get pictures developed anywhere, ever. Really, why would anyone get their pictures developed? I mean, you know, in a physical form. It doesn't make sense. You know, digital, you can put them up on Facebook, you can put them on websites, and people will see them. If you put them in a photo album, they're just going to be on a shelf forever. Oh, hi, is this Lisa?
Hello?
Hi, Lisa.
And this is?
Am I supposed to complete that sentence?
Am I supposed to know who you are?
I'm calling from... You had some... You came in to the kiosk today and did some prints?
Uh-huh.
And there's a problem.
What's wrong with it?
Well, not with the pictures exactly. It's just like, you know, we looked on the security cameras. And
right.
We saw that you shoplifted from us.
And yeah, I don't think so.
We need you... Oh, it's not a joke. Come on. We need you to bring back the merchandise and... You know, we want...
I didn't shoplift from anybody, so I don't know what kind of joke this is, but it's not very funny.
It's not funny to you. No, it's not a joke. Okay, we just need to bring the merchandise back, and then we won't have to...
I didn't take anything, so I don't know what you're talking about.
No, I mean, come on. You don't have to deny it. I mean, there's no sense in denying it, because we have you on the camera. We can...
Okay, what did I take?
On the VHS. You know what you took. We just need you to bring it back.
No, I don't need... I don't take anything. What are you talking about?
I mean, come on.
I didn't come in there today, okay?
Aren't you a little old to be shoplifting?
Aren't you a little old to be making up jokes? That's why you're calling from
Whoa.
861.
Zing.
Thank you.
You told me, didn't you? All right, she's gone. Let me try her again. Oh, she picked up in the middle of my rant against physical photos. Really, though, I mean, come on, unless you're going to put them in a frame. A lot of these people, like,
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic...
Let me try one more time. Like, Cindy. Cindy, she didn't answer earlier. She got 100 prints, 4x6s. The girl with the nip slip, she got 50 4x6 prints. What are you going to do with prints? You're going to put them in a photo album. They're going to be in a shelf forever. And, you know, maybe you're going to pull them out and show them to somebody someday. You're going to be like, hey, look through my photo album.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice.
Why would you do it that way, though? Why wouldn't you pull out your laptop and just look at albums on your Facebook or on your hard drive? God! Okay. All right, remember the nip slip people? Her name was Curran, and there was her brother Brian that she had incest relationships with. I'm going to hit the call group button, and I'm going to hope that they both pick up around the same time, which probably isn't going to happen, but we can hope. But I'm going to mute, and we're just going to see what they say to each other. And it's pointless. They're going to know it's me. They're going to see the caller ID, but here it goes. Let's see what happens.
You've reached Connie Hill. Sorry I missed you. If you could leave your name. Hello? Hi, you've reached Connie Hill. Hello? Hi, you've reached Connie Hill. Sorry I missed you. If you could leave your name, your number, and a message, I will be sure to get back to you. Thank you. Bye.
All right, that didn't work out too good. The person saying hello was Curran, and the person not answering was Brian's wife or whatever. But, yeah, I guess I will delete them. Okay. Remember the person earlier Veronica's husband or Veronica's boyfriend. He wouldn't let me talk to Veronica. He didn't even ask me who I was. I'm going to call him back and do a store survey. Nah, be quiet. Be quiet, Veronica.
Hi, you've reached 966-1486. Sorry, we're
not... All right, how does that happen? How did I hear just two different voicemails? That's pretty weird. This is the guy that was really pissed, and he's going to visit me, visit the store in the morning to tell me a thing or two, or talk to my manager, I guess. I'm getting tired. I think it's time to end.
I reached 9668.
Nah! Sorry, you guys. I didn't mean to yell in your ears.
Hi. You've reached 96. Sorry, we're not in. Please leave your name and number.
Okay, one more time. For Veronica. I think the other one was like a home answering machine, because it sounded kind of far off. Like maybe it forwards. Maybe I'm reaching a Google Voice and it rings several phones at once.
Hi, you reached not unavailable. Please leave a message. Thank you.
Hello? Pick up, pick up, pick up, pick up, pick up. Pick up your phone. Pick up your phone, Veronica. Pick up, pick up, pick up, pick up, pick up, pick up, pick up. Don't let that asshole guy pick up, though. I want to talk to you, because, you know, you're the only name that's on the form here. Pick up. Pick up. Pick up. Pick up. Pick up, pick up, pick up, Veronica. Pick up your phone. Gosh darn it, all the heck. Pick up, 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 pick up. Come on, Veronica, pick up your phone. I know you're there. Veronica, pick up the phone. Pick up the phone. Pick up the phone, Veronica. Pick up the phone. Pick up the phone. Veronica! Please, Veronica! Please, Veronica, pick up the phone. Pick up the phone. Pick up, pick up, pick up, pick up, pick up. Hold on. Veronica, pick up your phone. Pick up your phone. Click. It's gone. I don't know if my touch tones screwed it up. That was me, by the way. That wasn't them hitting touch tones. That was me. Science! All right, so I'm going to delete Veronica from my list. Here's one that I didn't put a note on, so... Hopefully I didn't reach her earlier. Her name was Yolanda. Let's give her a try. Science. Science. Not that I was trying to hack her machine or anything, because that'd be illegal. I don't do stuff like that.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message.
Let me try again.
Hello?
Oh, hi. Is this Yolanda?
Who's this?
Oh, I'm calling from the photo place. You got some kiosk prints made, 55 kiosk prints, the 1 hour delivery photos.
Oh, was that today?
I think it was today. Maybe it was yesterday. Because I'm just looking on the security tapes here. I mean, technically it was yesterday, because, you know, it's after midnight.
Yeah.
Well, not after midnight.
Did you call from the store?
Yeah, because we looked on the security tapes and there was a problem.
What's wrong with it?
Well, the pictures are fine. It's just that we looked on the security tapes and we saw that you stole some merchandise from us. You shoplifted?
No.
Yep, you did. It's okay. You don't have to deny it. But could you bring back the merchandise you stole? She hung up. Ow! Oops, sorry. Accident. That hurt my ears, too. Sorry, everyone. Goddamn Yolanda, though. Stupid Yolanda. Oh, hello? We got disconnected somehow.
Oh.
This isn't Yolanda.
No, this is Paul. Oh, I live with Yolanda.
Hi, Paul. Yeah,
Yolanda. Yeah, we got some photos from there.
Yeah, from the kiosk. You got like 55 kiosk prints? The 1 hour prints?
Yes. Is there a problem with that?
Well, then after the kiosk prints, Yolanda went on a shoplifting spree. Like, did you have your eye on her the whole time? Because she stole some things from us.
Yolanda is a Christian, and she's going to be my fiance. She's my fiance and my soon-to-be wife.
Oh, you might want to reconsider that if you're a Christian, because she's not a Christian. She steals things.
Will you describe Yolanda to me for me?
Well, it's hard to see on this black and white security tape, but it was definitely her. She was at the kiosk with you. And then she went off by herself, and she stole some batteries.
And, wait a minute. You're telling me you see her stealing batteries and what else?
She stole...
We're going to come down there right now.
Right now? Why right now?
Because I want to resolve this right now.
Can she bring back the batteries that she stole from us?
I know who Yolanda is.
Right.
I know her character, and I know
Well, was she with you the whole time? Because she went off on her own, and she stole some things. Maybe she's got a problem, and you guys need to address the problem.
She's...
I mean, I'm sorry. I feel like a jerk, you know, accusing her, but it's definitely her. Because, I mean, we were able to tell because right after we were at the kiosk, she, you know, stole some things.
We're going to come over there and we're going to set this straight.
And then she went to the pharmacy and she robbed the pharmacy. She stole a bunch of Vicodin and soda pop.
Oh, yeah. Now you know even from CVS pharmacy. You know even because there's not.
CVS.
I was there with her number one.
CVS. What are you talking about? CVS.
Where are you? I'm sorry.
The different company. Like you don't even know where you were. Are you both addicted to pain pills?
All right. Sir, you're making me very angry now.
Well, I think you're both drug addicts, and you're both stealing from us then.
Ah, I see this.
She stole
it.
She also stole a transvestite magazine and a case of beer and some vodka.
Yeah, now I know for sure that you're just pulling our legs. Thank you very much.
Really, I'm pulling your legs. I would call this late to pull your leg. That doesn't make any sense.
Well,
I mean, she's on tape right here.
To me either, but you are definitely not saying the truth because you know who number one. Number two, you are defaming her character, and number three, she had never do anything of that nature, and you know better yourself.
I know better. I don't even know Yolanda. I just know what she did on our security tapes. And if you want to come in right now, I'll show you the tapes.
All right, we're coming in right now.
Okay. Bye. Oh, no. Ray Bob, he said that she smoked meth in the parking lot, and I wanted to say that, but then on the other hand, I kind of want them to get out of bed and go to right now to find out is probably closed, but I don't know. They're probably going to call and find out that they're closed. What else? let's try this one. It's another kiosk. I'm pretty sure she was also a shoplifter. Her name is Joan. That sounds like a shoplifter name. It's another one that didn't answer earlier. But maybe I got her woke up a little bit from my ringing earlier. I hope they go to the store. That'd be...
Please leave your message for...
Two more times. So I need you guys to subscribe to some Facebooks if you're not subscribed to them already. You need to go to... Oh, man. I think the URL is facebook.com/prankcalls. Maybe it's facebook.com/prankphonecalls, but I think it's just prank calls. That's an important URL. You need to subscribe to that. You guys need to stop being subscribed to Cacti Radio. That place is dead. And subscribe to /prankcalls on Facebook.
Please leave your message.
One more time. And also, besides /prankcalls, you need to subscribe. Shut up, Urza. You're going to subscribe to everything I say. You need to subscribe to facebook.com/telephonefalls. You need to subscribe to that because that's a project I'm working on and it's going to be completed within a month or two. No, Dick Soup. We're not going to subscribe to that page. I wonder if that page exists. Let's try that out.
Please leave your message for 91.
Sorry, this page isn't available. So I guess I won't tell the listeners what page Dick Soup is suggesting that you subscribe to. But no, subscribe to facebook.com/prankcalls, facebook.com/telephonefalls. Prank calls has... you know, like YouTube links to prank calls and sometimes MP3s. And Telephone Falls is another thing I'm working on. Dark Stranger says everyone needs to subscribe to facebook.com/darkstranger. With two R's on the end. I don't know if that's real or if she's just drunk. Let's find out. Hey, it is two R's on the end. Dark Stranger with two R's on the
Please
end.
Please leave your message for 916.
All right. One more time. I'm going to try this lady one more time. Is Urza making fun of me? Did I get the wrong URL? Prank calls. Oh, no, it's prank phone calls. Damn it. Yeah, it's facebook.com/prankphonecalls. I'm dumb. I should write this shit down. All right, Joan's not going to answer. I'm going to delete her. Let's try this one. Her name's Robin. She didn't answer earlier. Prank phone calls. Some kind of craziness is happening in the chat room right now. Cool Rob is saying that Ken is a DDoS.
Hi, this is Robin, but I can't get to the phone right now. Leave a message so I can get back to you. Thanks. Bye-bye.
Hey, Robin. I'm calling from... you got a passport photo down here earlier. Been trying to get a hold of you because we saw the security tape and we know what you did. We know what you did. And you need to come back. And you need to bring that stuff back that you took. So we need to see you back here ASAP, Robin. Or else, you know, we're going to have to report you for what you did. So please come back. Thank you. That should be some nice confusion for her. Either in the morning or in the middle of the night if she checks them right now. Okay, here's one more. This is the last one I'm going to be able to try. It was another no answer, and I've already called it several times, and she never picked up. I think this is the one that I accidentally let her number go out over the air earlier.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system. 9 1 6 8 0.
All right, good night, everyone. See you next time. Hey, Stacy.
Yeah?
Hey, it's Roy.
Hi.
I'm making chocolate chip cookies, and it says to put in 2.5 cups of flour, but that seems like a lot of flour. Like, do you think that's right? I mean, I don't want to make that many cookies, really. But...
I don't know.
I mean, you want me to tell you the other ingredients? Because I have to put in 3 eggs. Like, does that sound right? Like, 3 eggs... And then 2.5 yeah. cups of flour?
Yeah.
That's a shitload of flour. Holy shit.
Who was this again?
Roy. I mean, seriously, though? Like, 3 eggs equals 2.5 cups of flour?
I think.
Because I don't even have a mixer. I have to do this all by hand.
Yeah.
Can I come over and borrow your mixer?
No.
Why not?
Where'd you get my number?
Facebook?
Dude, you need to stop bothering me because I'm not in the mood.
What? No, I just need to know about the flour and the cookies. They're chocolate chip. They're chocolate chip.
Hello?
Hi. Can I talk to Stacy? Because I don't think you would know anything about my cookies.
Dude, right now, she don't even know anything about cookies. Okay, you need to stop calling this number.
This is the first time I've called.
Okay, well, right now, we need to keep this line open because we're trying to locate our daughter, okay?
You don't need to act like I've been calling all night and you don't have call waiting because I know people can still call you while we're talking.
Okay, are you calling her and asking her about cookies?
It's called call waiting because she put her number on Facebook, so I'm just trying to ask a simple question.
Okay, so you call people via Facebook just because they have their phone number up there?
Well, everyone in my family's asleep right now, so I can't call them.
Okay, so you just call some random person on Facebook that has their number up there who is trying to locate their daughter.
Well, how would I know that? I'm just asking about cookies. I'm not talking about daughters. I just needed to know this question, and she answered it for me. So why don't you just fuck off? I mean, we're done. She answered my question. I'm finished.
I now have your phone number.
Asshole.
I'm dialing the cops and giving them your number and letting them call you.
You're going to call the cops because I asked about cookies? Do you know how big of a retard you're going to sound like?
You know what? Right now, I don't really give a flying fuck.
Yeah, have fun telling the cops that somebody called and asked you about cookies. They're going to arrest you for abusing the 911 system. And he's gone.
I was good one more time of coffee in my coffee cup, and out of the corner of my eyes I saw two guys come in. One with the black hoodie, one with the white hoodie, black hoodie, white hoodie. They said, "We want your money, everybody down." And I'm like, "Oh, why do you need coffee now?" And so the guy in black shirt's coming down, 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 down. And I'm backing up, backing up, backing up, backing up. My daddy taught me good. I'm backing in a lot of there, and I'm like, "Oh my god, oh my god, my god." I'm backing up, backing up, backing up, backing up. My daddy taught me good, and I think maybe I should faint, but I don't. My daddy taught me good. So I back farther and farther away, and I'm like, "Don't look, don't look, don't look." And he comes right to him, and he goes, "Get down now, get down now." And I just drop to my knees, see my little knee. And then when I figure out I'm safe, I'm like, count the 2,000, and I don't hear nothing, nothing. Then I hear, no, no, no. I'm like, oh my god, they're dead. So I'm backing up, backing up.
Hello?
Oh, hi, is this Jennifer?
Yes, it is.
Oh, hi, I'm calling from Walmart. My name is Kevin. I'm the manager here.
Hi.
Hi, I'm just calling to do a reference check for Joanna Wright. Joanna Wright.
Okay.
And she listed you as a reference and just...
Yeah, I've known her a long time since high school.
Oh, really? And you guys are just friends or family?
Just friends. I've known her since high school. We were classmates in high school.
Oh, okay. And you're just still pretty close friends then?
Yeah, I see her maybe about once a month or so.
Okay. And then, is there any drug use or alcohol abuse or anything like that with Joanna?
No, she's always been, you know, straightforward with, you know, not doing that stuff.
Oh, because she wrote...
She's always been a Christian and stuff like that.
Oh, I see. Yeah, she wrote on the application that she uses marijuana 1 to 2 times a week, and that she drinks daily.
I didn't know anything about that.
Oh, I see. So you're
as far as I know, she doesn't. I mean, I've never seen her.
It seems like you're not being honest with me. If, I mean, like you said, she doesn't ever drink, and so maybe you're not a good reference check to have for her. I'm gonna write down on here that you lied to me, and I think maybe we shouldn't hire her.
It's the music that we choose. It's the music that we choose. It's the music that we choose. Oh, it's the music that we choose. It's the music that we choose. It's the music that we choose. The music that we choose. The world is spinning too fast. I'm fine that Nike shoes. To keep myself tethered to the days I tried to lose. My mind.
Damn you, Eddie.
You're calling.
So this is my new amazing Facebook idea. You find somebody that posted their number on Facebook, and then you look at their friends, and you do a reference check on one of their friends. Say you're with Walmart.
Please leave your message for...
Marty.
Marty? It's spelled M-A-R-I. Let's try again. I think they hit the button. These people are in Texas. So
please leave your message for...
Okay, maybe they didn't hit the button. But yeah, it worked out really great on that girl I talked to a minute ago.
Hello?
Oh, hi. Is this Mari Sutton?
Hello?
Hi, is this Mari Sutton?
Yes.
Oh, I'm calling from Walmart. I'm calling to do a reference check.
A reference check?
Yes, on the name is Sarita Gilstrap. She's applying for a job here, and she listed you as a personal reference.
Oh, yeah, but it's 2 in the morning over here.
Right, yeah, I work the night shift. So, I mean, could you recommend her as a good employee? Like, do you know her and everything?
Yes, she's a good employee. She's a good person, yeah.
Oh, okay. She doesn't drink or use drugs or anything like that?
Oh, no, she doesn't. No.
You've never known her to steal?
No.
She listed on her application here. She says that she smokes marijuana 1 to 2 times a week. And I mean, I consider that a drug. I don't know if you do, but that's a drug.
Is this some kind of a joke or something? I
Oh,
mean, it's
no,
fucking
ma'am.
2 in the morning.
No, I wouldn't call this late for a joke. I'm just calling to do the reference check so we can get her hired.
Well, my thing is that she's applying for a job and she listed under she did drugs. Why the fuck would you call me?
Well, no, I mean, she just,
at 2 in the morning.
She was being honest on her application. I mean, it's not
Okay, and I'm being
necessarily.
honest right now. It's fucking 2 in the morning and your ass just woke me up
Okay.
to ask me some
Well, I
stupid
mean,
question.
you don't need to curse at me because if you curse at me,
I do. I
maybe I'm
well,
not going to
my thing is,
hire her.
I do need to curse at you for calling and waking my ass up at 2 in the morning.
Maybe I don't need to hire Sarita
Yeah.
if you're just going
Well,
to
then
curse
don't
at me.
fucking hire her. I don't give a damn what
Okay.
you do.
Well,
If
I'm going to
you're
tell
the one
her.
who works at
I'm going to
Walmart.
tell her I was ready to hire her, and then you had to like
I don't
just
give a
give her a
damn what
bad
you tell
reference.
her. I don't care what you tell
So
her.
you're not a good
You tell
reference
her
then?
whatever the
Like
hell you want to tell her.
you don't even like her? Like why'd she list you as a
But I
reference
don't.
if you're going to be a bitch? Ma'am, do you want to answer that? Ma'am? Oh, she hung up. Why? Let's try again. She's not. I don't think Sarita should use her as a reference check anymore in the future.
Please leave your message for
Marty.
Oh, hello. I was just calling to do that reference check on Sarita Gilstrap, and I mean, apparently you're not a very good friend because you just cursed at me and yelled at me and stuff. So I guess we're not going to be hiring her. So I guess you didn't want your friend to have a job after all. So whatever. Die in hell. Rot in hell. God damn it. Die in hell. What the hell am I saying? I think it's time for me to go to sleep. Okay. Let's try a couple more. But see, isn't that a great idea? You look up somebody's number on Facebook. I can't remember what the website is because it changes when I actually go to it. Hold on. It's Open Book. No, it's not Open Book. It's a bizarre URL. williamuffat.github.io/ Facebook search. I will try and put that whenever I convert this to the podcast feed. I'll try and put the URL on the website on phonelosers.org. But yeah, you find somebody that posted a number, then you look at their friends, and you do a reference check on one of their friends' names. So far, I've gotten lucky on 2 in a row. They've actually recognized the friends. I wouldn't recognize half of the friends on mine.
Is this thing on?
Okay, so I'm gonna look for another one. Be right back.
So what, we get drunk. So what, we smoke weed. We're just having fun. We don't care who sees.
Oh, shit.
So what, we go out.
Let me get a lighter.
That's how it's
Please.
supposed to be.
Cause you know I'm high as
Living
fuck and I'm
young
gone.
and wild
Keep that in there.
and free. That's how it's supposed to be. Living young.
At the tone.
What the hell was that? I couldn't understand anything. Something about a wrong number. I'm tired. It's time to quit.
Wrong number. Leave your message at the sound.
No. Please, don't.
At the tone, please.
Wow. It's like those, in the 80s, people would purchase cassette tapes full of hilarious answering machine messages. And it's like they're using one of those or something. I mean, I don't know. Maybe somebody else recognizes what that is, but I sure don't know what that was. It sounded like it was supposed to be hilarious, but I couldn't understand it. I'm scrolling through these Facebook posts still, trying to find some, just another couple of these. Another thing I want to do to Facebook people, but it's something you can only do during the daytime. Oh, here's one. I think this is Louisiana. Okay. I'm going to call this before I even click on her profile to see if I can see her friends. Her name is Tammy. Yes, Ice Goose, there's a show right now. Aren't you listening? Ken, you're still listening.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system. 3-3.
Ken, you need to suck a long cock. That's what Rob says. I'm pretty sure that means Rob is gay, and he finds you attractive, and he wants you to suck his long cock. He's bragging about his long cock, and he wants you to suck it, Ken. So please, suck Cool Rob's long cock. Maybe you guys can private message each other and have some cyber sex.
Hello?
Oh, hello. Did I reach Tammy?
Yes, you did.
Oh, okay. I'm calling from Walmart. My name is Roy. I'm the manager here. I'm just calling to do a reference check on Megan Russo.
Uh-huh.
She's just trying to get a job here, and she listed you as a personal reference.
Yes, sir. Megan Russo from New Iberia. Yes, sir.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So you could recommend her as a good employee and everything?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
She doesn't do drugs or drink or anything like that?
No, sir. She's got three kids, and she's a mom. No, I've been knowing her for about 9 or 10 years now. She's real good friends with my daughter.
Oh, okay. Great. I mean, we do kind of a thorough background check and everything, and we managed to find her Facebook, and we see that there's a picture of you and Megan here, and you have like joints in your hand, like you're smoking weed and beers.
Me and Megan?
Yeah. There's a picture of you where you're both tagged in it, and you're
both. Nah, I don't think so.
You've got like lines of cocaine in front of you on the table.
We got what?
Cocaine. It looks like.
No, not me and Megan, not cooking.
Well, I mean, it says...
We do pageants. We don't do meals together.
Oh, pageants? Is that some kind of a new drug that I haven't heard about? Because I'm not too up on the drug stuff. But, I mean, it shows Tammy Myers here is tagged in the photo. And then it shows
no,
Megan Russo.
No.
Well, I mean, it looks...
That is not me, but Megan is a good mom, and I'm going to end this conversation, and I'm going to end this call now.
You know, moms, they can be drug addicts, too. They like, you know, moms get in trouble all the time for drugs.
And you said you're from where?
I'm calling from Walmart. My name is Roy. Who's telling you to hang up on me? Oh, she hung up on me. Why'd she hang up on me? I don't get it. I'm so confused. Oh, well. I'm going to try and find another one. I'm not too tired yet. I'm going to try and call another one. Be right back. BRB.
Until your party answers the phone.
Oh, this is so much better music. Woo!
Hello?
Oh, hello. Is this Misty?
Yes.
Oh, hi. This is Roy. I'm the manager over here at Walmart. We had a Regina Fox. She was applying for a job here, and she left your number as a personal reference.
Who?
Regina. Regina Fox.
Yes.
Yeah, she's trying to apply for a job here at Walmart, and she left you as a personal reference.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, she like, do you know Regina? Like, you think she'd be a good employee and everything?
Oh, yes.
Like, I mean, she wouldn't steal from her employer or anything like that.
Oh, no.
Are you sure about that? Because, I mean, she wrote some stuff on here in her application. You don't think she'd steal from her employer?
No.
Because she wrote here that she, at her last job, she stole 1 to 2 times a week from her employer. You know, she's just being honest on her survey here.
Well, we must be talking about two different people.
Oh, Regina.
And why would Walmart call me at this time at night?
She left you as a personal reference. I mean, it's got to be the same person, right? I don't think. I mean, is this you? I mean, this is Misty Ward.
Walmart don't call people at this hour at night.
Oh, really? Do you work at Walmart?
I shop at Walmart all right. The time.
But you're not a manager or an employer at Walmart? She's gone. Let's try again. How would she know when we do our reference checks?
Music until your party answers the phone.
I think this is a good tactic, actually. Hello?
Hello?
Oh, hi, Misty. We got disconnected somehow. Like, how would you know if you're not an employee here? How would you know what time we do our reference checks? We like to call late at night to catch people, you know, when they're most honest. Because, you know, when you're just waking up, you're more inclined to tell the truth about people.
You're talking about Regina Fox that just buried her husband?
Right. Yeah, she's applying for a job here.
At what Walmart?
Well, I'm not at liberty to tell you. I mean, you could be an identity thief.
Well, then, if you can't tell me what Walmart, then why are you calling me? This just don't make sense.
We're not going to hire her if you're going to tell us that she's like a thief and a drug addict.
No, she's not a thief or a drug addict.
Oh, okay. That's all we're asking for. We're just trying to get a good reference check on her. That's all we need. But, I mean, we
did... Why can't you tell me what Walmart you're with so I can verify that
someone
this,
here
is,
in...
this is a real call?
Well, how are you going to verify it? Are you going to call me back? I can give you a number to call me back at. If you'd like a number to call me back at.
No, so I can call the Walmart.
Well, yeah, I'm at the Walmart. Do you want the Walmart's number so you can call us back?
Tell me what your name is.
Roy. I've told you that several times already.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I did. I said, I'm calling from Walmart. My name's Roy. I'm the manager here. The general manager. That's the first thing I said to you when I called, but you probably don't remember because you were asleep. But yeah, she says she stole from her previous employer like 1 to 2 times a week when she did her survey
previous
here.
Employer?
Well, I'm not at liberty to give out that kind of information. But you're saying she doesn't steal from employees, and it says here that she does. So are you lying to just protect her? Because you need to be honest about it.
Why would I lie to protect somebody?
Well, I don't know. If you wanted to get the job, I can see why you would lie.
I don't understand. I've never known of her stealing anything.
Oh. Well, we did a background check on her, and, I mean, we found Facebook pictures of you and her doing cocaine together.
You're a lying son of a bitch.
Why do you say that?
You motherfucker, who are you?
My name's Roy. I've told
you
that.
I do drugs.
3 times now. No, no, we have pictures of you and her doing drugs together.
You're a liar.
You're tagged in one of her photos on Facebook.
You're a fucking liar.
Oh, don't curse at me, or I'm not going to hire her.
Well, I'm calling the cops, because you fucking just called me and told me said I've done cocaine.
You're going to call the cops because I'm doing a reference check?
I've got cancer, and I don't do any kind of drugs.
Well, you know, like, I don't see that
you
as an excuse.
Shit, you lying piece of fucking shit.
Are you really going to call the...
Fucking, you know what? God's gonna punish you for what you just done.
What? Doing a reference check? This is my job. This is what I do for
That's
a living.
That's not a reference check. Telling me that you got a picture of me doing cocaine, and I don't do drugs.
Well, I'm sorry. No, I'm just trying to do a reference check on Misty. It's not about you.
You know what I'll do?
You don't have to prove yourself to me.
And I will do a blood test, and then I'm gonna sue your ass.
You're gonna sue me after you do a blood test? How does that make sense?
That's right. Proving to you that you're a lying piece of shit.
Okay.
You motherfucker, you call me and call me. You say you got pictures of me doing cocaine.
Well, maybe it's Regina that lies, because, I mean, it shows here on the application. She said she admitted that she does drugs occasionally, recreationally.
Well, I don't know what Regina you're talking about, but I tell you what.
It's Regina
Fox. You ain't got no pictures of me doing any kind of drugs, because I don't do drugs, and neither does she.
Maybe she tagged the photo.
That woman just married her husband.
Maybe she tagged the photo incorrectly, and she said it was you, but maybe it's not you. But she tagged the photo, and it says Misty on it.
You know what? I don't know who put you up to this, but whoever put you up to this.
Uh-huh.
Is going to pay, because I'm going to call the sheriff's department.
You're going to call the sheriff's
number. So I want to know what Walmart you're with right now. Are you with Mountain View, West Plains, Thayer, Arkansas? What Walmart you with?
No, I'll give you the Walmart phone number if you guys want to call back and have the sheriff.
I want to know the town.
I know
Walmart.
The sheriff personally, because we have him out here all the time to deal with shoplifters and you know, people that do cocaine like you.
You piece of shit. You are such a liar. You're calling
me. I'm
not lying. Somebody just put you up to call me to ask me some stupid shit. And I don't even know what the fuck you're talking about.
Why don't you go on Facebook right now and check? You look at your tagged photos and you'll see you're on there doing cocaine with her. But I'm just like, she was being honest about the kind of drugs she does. So, I mean, I'm not accusing you of anything. I'm just saying, like... You're saying she doesn't steal.
I'm telling you, whoever says that I am on Facebook doing drugs.
Well, maybe she just mistagged the photo. Maybe it's somebody else. But you're saying
You know what? God is going to punish you for what you just said.
No, I'm not saying anything
wrong. For my life, and you just saying I do cocaine.
Well, okay, if you don't do cocaine, that's fine. Maybe it's just a mistake. Okay, she's gone. Ice Goose says to send her to Meat Spin. It's too late. It's too late, Ice Goose. I already called her back once. I think it's... All right, let me find somebody else. The Brady Bunch. It's the Brady Bunch. The Brady Bunch. All right, I'm trying Ronald. Gonna get a male this time.
Hello?
Oh, hello, is this Ronald?
Yes, it is. Who is this?
Oh, I'm calling from Walmart. I'm the general manager here. My name's Roy.
Uh-huh.
And I'm just calling to do a reference check on a young woman that was wanting to do get a job here. Her name's Evelyn Eva.
Okay.
And she just listed you as a personal reference. Do you know any...
What are they expecting you to call at 12:30 in the morning?
Yeah, she listed the best time to call, and it said was right now. But, I mean, do you know Evelyn then? Like she?
I sure do. I've known Evelyn since we were in junior high.
Oh, I see. Okay.
And she's always been reliable.
Okay, reliable. She didn't think she'd steal or use drugs or anything like that?
No.
Okay, because we checked. We did kind of a background check and found her on Facebook. And it shows we have a picture here of you and her using marijuana together.
What? it's impossible for me to use marijuana because I haven't used marijuana since high school, and I haven't seen her since.
Oh, maybe this is an older picture then. Maybe she tagged you in it, it looks like.
It's not me, guaranteed. It's not me.
Oh, okay. She must have missed.
Because she hasn't been in the state of Arizona since we were in eighth grade.
Oh,
this and I didn't touch weed until much later.
Oh, okay. This must be an old photo then, because she's got you tagged in it. But I mean, she's pretty honest though. She wouldn't steal from employers or.
No, like I don't believe she would.
I don't know. She looks like a fucking. I've got a pretty fucking thief to me.
I got a pretty high. So what?
I don't know. She looks like a goddamn thief to me. Just looking at her face,
really?
I think she's the kind of person that would try to like steal from the register.
I don't think she's that way, but if that's your opinion, then you do what you got to do.
Yeah, well, no,
I don't think she'd do it.
That's just my opinion. I'm just trying to get your opinion to help sway my
opinion. Yeah, I don't believe she'd do that.
Really?
She's a mother, and she has things to take care of.
Okay, all right. Yeah, but you're a drug user, so I don't know if I can trust your opinion. Do you think she's the type of person?
Sir, no, I am not a drug user.
Well, no, I mean, told me that you'd smoked, you have smoked marijuana.
I smoked weed and I got in trouble for it and I stopped using it.
Ah, okay. So if you
do something like this again, excuse me, and if you start
you are a drug user then.
Again, no, I am not a drug user.
Yeah, I mean, you've used drugs, so that makes you a drug user.
No, that does not make me a drug user. A drug user is someone who uses drugs on a regular basis.
Okay. Do you think she's the kind of person that would, like, maybe suck my cock to get ahead in the, you know, up the chain, the ladder, the corporate ladder, like, to get a promotion? That made him hang up for some reason. Let me try and call him back. I forgot his name already. Oh, Ronald.
Please leave your message for 480326.
Oh, man, I hope I didn't let the whole number out. Okay. All right, I'm tired of that song. Yes, yes, Dick Soup, I saw your PM, and I'm calling this girl named Emily right now. Let's see if Emily answers. One of her likes is the TV show Weeds. Let's see her try and deny that she smokes weed. Oops. Oh, hi, is Emily there? Hello? Hello? Oops. I think she heard me say, let's hear her deny she smokes weed. I think I fucked that one up. I'm sorry, Dick Soup. He sent me a Facebook person, though, that listed her phone number. Hello? Oh, hello. Is this Emily?
Yeah.
Hello? I can't hear you.
Yeah, this is
Emily. Oh, can you turn the phone the other way so I can hear you? Hello?
Yeah, this is Emily.
Oh, there you go. Oh, I'm calling from Walmart. My name is Roy. I'm just calling to do a reference check. Someone listed you as a personal reference. Her name is Kathy Henney. Do you know
what is her name?
Her name's Kathy Henney. She listed you as a personal reference.
Okay.
I mean, she listed you as a reference for someone she's worked for. She says she worked for you for 1 year as she was a painter.
And, I don't know anybody by that name.
You don't know Kathy Henney?
No.
How do you not know Kathy Henney?
I just don't.
She currently.
Are you sure you have the right number?
Yeah, she listed your number. Is this Emily Davenport?
Yeah.
She listed you. She listed also as a personal reference, Megan Motor. Do you know Megan Motor?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so you must know Kathy then. She says she worked for you for a year and a half.
I really don't know anybody by that name.
Oh. What the fuck? I mean, why would she list you as a reference? That's weird. That's bizarre. That's crazy. That's crazy. Crazy! Hello, Emily?
Yeah, are we done?
Emily? I can't hear you. You did the thing with the phone again.
Are we done?
Oh, well, that's crazy. I mean, I think you know her and you're just trying to cover up something. Like, what have you got to hide?
What is this? Like,
it's a reference check. You've never done a reference check before? Hello? 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 Thank you for that, Dick Soup. I kind of messed that one up. But that was one of her friends that had liked one of her recent posts, so I figured she would know her. But somehow she doesn't know this person that likes her posts, or she's covering something up. I don't know.
Democracy. Yeah, I got.
I should tell the person that I'm doing the reference check with that they need to take a drug test. We're going to send someone out right now to have you pee in a cup. To make sure that she's reliable. Oh, man. I really want to do this one. She looked good. I still have half a Four Loko left. That's like two beers. I think next time I do a show, I could just do the entire show of just this. Just doing reference checks on people. And I'm going to do that thing I did just last time that didn't work out. But I want to say that the person... I want to tell them lies. Like, the person says they worked for you.
Please enter your remote access code.
Okay. Oh, it hung up. Let me try again. The touch tones should wake them up. I just injected 32 marijuanas into my arm to celebrate, 420. Even though that's over. All right, I'll try someone else. Kin. Kin is Satan. Satan.
Please enter your remote access code.
This guy's name is John. He's a single needing real friends, honest women. So if you're interested in getting to know John better, he has two cell phone numbers. All is welcome for chat. So hit up a real man. He's honest. He's true. He's faithful. He's easygoing.
Hey. What are you doing?
I'm not falling for that.
Well...
Oh, hi. Is this...
He's really talking to me, though, right?
Oh, God damn it. I fell for it.
I'm sorry I missed your call, but call me back later.
All right. Bye. So this John, who is really desperate for a woman, has a female on his answering machine message who successfully tricked me just now. He's easygoing. He loves to laugh. He loves to make people smile and feel good about themselves. So if you're looking for something real and something real fast and something just to get into, John's your man. So check John out, ladies.
I'm sorry, but the person you called has a voice mailbox that has not been set up yet.
Oh, come on. John seems hilarious. I really want to talk to John. OMG. Hi, Carlito. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Oh, hi, is this John?
Yeah, who's this?
Oh, hi, this is Roy. I'm calling from Walmart.
Walmart?
Yeah, I'm just calling to do a reference check on Casey Mason. She left you as a personal, as a reference.
Right.
Do you know Casey Mason?
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay. Yeah, she left you as a reference. She said she worked for you for about a year and a half.
Right.
And that she did secretary work.
Yeah.
Can you just, I don't know, give me an idea of, was she a good employee and everything?
Do what now?
Was she a good employee?
Oh, yeah. Always on time. Kept a tidy workspace.
All right.
Very intelligent.
How many hours a week did she... Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Great manners, very respectful.
Okay. Well, what kind of work did she do for you then?
Just clerical work, more or less.
Oh, yeah?
Did put my paperwork and stuff. Made sure that my invoices and all that good stuff was taken care of.
Oh, okay. What kind of business was that then?
I did welding, mechanicing,
all right.
Auto body.
You need a lot of secretarial work for that kind of thing?
Well, yeah, there's a lot of incoming and outgoing money and parts ordering and paying.
Oh yeah.
Materials.
She says in here she smoked a lot of weed with you. Did a lot of cocaine and stuff with you.
Oh Lord, no.
Oh, I mean she wrote that on here. I mean she's just being honest on her application, I think.
For real?
Yeah.
I'm gonna get that girl.
I'm sorry, what?
I said, I'm going to get that girl.
Oh, really? Oh, no. I mean, she's just, you know.
Drug that on her?
Yeah, I mean, like, yeah, we just ask questions about, basic questions about drugs and alcohol use, and I think she's just trying
to. Please remove that. Remove my name from there.
Oh, why is that?
Because that's slandering, whatever, however you say it.
It's slandering?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I mean, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I don't do drugs, so...
Oh, okay.
Therefore, I don't want my name in any contact with it.
It's okay to lie, though, about you know, hiring her and being her boss?
Oh, I'm not lying.
You're not?
No. I have no need to lie.
Oh, really? So she was really a secretary?
I can reach forward with someone and tell them the truth, and I don't got nothing to say to them.
Oh, because it says here on the application she didn't really work for you. She just wanted to see if you would lie for her.
Right. She did. She has helped me out during work.
Oh, yeah. How much did you pay her per hour?
About $6.70-something.
Oh, really? That's below minimum wage. I think that's illegal. Do I need to report you to the government?
That's what you feel necessary there, buddy.
Oh, okay. Because, I mean, that's illegal. You shouldn't be paying people under minimum wage. That's illegal. It's pretty basic law. Everyone should know that. If you're an actual...
That's all you can pay.
If you're an actual employer, you should know what minimum wage is.
All right, but that's all you're bringing in. That's all you can pay.
Really? You think that she's like a Mexican? You can just pay her under the table and stuff?
Oh, no.
You think that's okay?
No.
Why would you do that, then? Why would you pay her below minimum wage? You think she just wouldn't notice?
My buddy, fuck this shit. I ain't sitting here arguing.
Oh, my goodness. You're going to curse at me? I mean, I'm not going to hire her if she's going to have friends that curse at me. He's gone. All right. Bye.
I'm making my name.
I actually don't know if $6.70 is on our minimum wage. Is it? I think it is. Isn't minimum wage like $7 or $8 now? I'm trying to call this guy named Mike now. I should call that guy back and just be like, I don't know. Who would I say I am? I'm with the wages. What would I say I am if I wanted to, like, arrest him for hiring illegal immigrants or something? No, I'm not going to do that because I don't even know what to say. I don't know what department to say I'm with or anything. All right, I'm scrolling past that one. Oh, here's one that says her cell phone is MIA. That's appropriate. I didn't mean to reset that song. God damn it. You know, when I first heard that song on the radio, I tried to find the uncensored version. Because I figured those gunshots and those cash register noises were curse words or something. And there was some, you know, extra words in there that I wasn't hearing. But nope, that's the actual song, apparently.
Your call has been forwarded to Kudos Voice Messaging Center.
Kudos. That's Canadian. Sloth says I should say I'm the Department of Homeland Security. Internal Revenue Systems is what Evil Idea says. Carlito says I have to stay on for 3 more hours because he's at work for 3 more hours.
Your call has been forwarded okay. to Kudos Voice Messaging Center. 5198 5.
MIA, third world democracy. Yeah.
Trying another one. Oh, yeah. I should click on his profile so I know his friends' names.
You've reached Alan Jackson. I'm sorry I can't take your call at this time. At the sound of the beep, please leave me your name and number, including your area code.
Let's try him again. Cool Rob says, fuck Carlitos. He allows Ken to ban me from Madhouse for nothing. For nothing! God damn you, Carlitos! God damn you, Ken! What the fuck? Oh, hello?
Yeah.
Oh, is this Alan?
Yeah.
Oh, hi, I'm calling from Walmart. My name's Roy. I'm the general manager here. I was just calling to do a reference check on Kristen Boyd. She listed you as a reference. Hello? Oh, shit. Now that I look at Kristen Boyd's picture, she looks like she's, you know, 6. Oops. Let's try again. Also, I think you heard me yelling at Carlito and fucking Ken banning Cool Rob for nothing. For nothing! For nothing! What the fuck, Ken? God! Oh, crap, I'm calling Cool Rob. I didn't mean to call Cool Rob. I'm trying to call this guy. I don't want to call Cool Rob. He's just going to yell at me. All right, let's... Oops. Damn you, Four Loko. I still have half of Four Loko. That's like
two... You've reached Alan Jackson. I'm sorry I can't take your call at this time. At the sound of the beep, please leave me your name and number, including your area.
I think I'm going to go check on my hamster.
As soon as possible. Thanks.
At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1.
I think this is Kristen's daughter. It's not really Kristen. Oh, hi. I'm just calling to do a reference check on Kristen Boyd. But since you hung up on me, I guess I'm not going to hire her if she has the kind of friends that are just going to hang up on me. Fucking asshole. So whatever. Whatever. Maybe jobs aren't important to you. But Kristen, she's not going to have a job thanks to you. And I'm going to tell her it's your fault, asshole. There. That teaches him a thing or two.
Welcome again to this neighborhood. I'd like to show you something. You know what this is? Or maybe if I press this button. This is a cassette player with a little cassette in here. And there's nothing written on it.
Just the two of us.
And when we ride.
Just the two of us.
Just the two of us.
Please leave your message for 3471. Please leave your message for 34.
Oh, crap. Did I play that number?
You
damn
ever
it.
Need me, I'm always be here for you. If you ever need anything, just ask. Dad will be right there.
Here, this is for Ice Goose. I'm still looking up numbers, but I'm going to quit soon. I'm ready for bed.
Thinking of you again.
You don't know how sick you make me.
You have reached a Sasktown Mobility voice message.
Whoa. I got a million reasons off the top of my head that I could think of. 16 bars, this ain't enough to put some inks up. So fuck it, I'ma start right here. I'll just be brief up. About to rattle off some of the reasons. I knew I shouldn't go and get another tattoo of you.
Hello?
Oh, hi, I'm sorry. Is Danielle there?
Who's this?
Oh, my name's Roy. I'm calling from Walmart to do a reference check.
Okay, this is Danielle.
Oh, you sound like a man. I'm just calling to do a reference check on Jennifer Eves. She left you as a reference check. She's trying to get a job here at Walmart.
Okay.
Do you know Jennifer Eves?
Yes.
Oh, okay. And she says she worked for you for 8 months. She was a... can you explain what kind of work she did for you?
The house cleaning.
House cleaning?
Being,
oh, she says she didn't.
Even though it's 4:15 in the morning.
Yeah, she wrote down that this would be the best time to call. She says she did secretary work. It was house cleaning?
Oh, she was working in the business with me. I mean,
oh.
I did need help with books.
Which business paperwork. Which business was that?
No, I do it on the side on my own.
I'm sorry, what?
I do it on my own at home.
Oh, really? What kind of business?
Just like house cleaning and
house cleaning. She needed a secretary for house cleaning.
Yeah, but she was in charge of doing my papers.
Oh, I see. Papers for house cleaning.
Like, you know, the ledger, the books.
Oh yeah, the books for house cleaning.
Keep track of everything.
Oh,
well, yeah,
yeah,
we got to keep track of our customers.
Oh yeah, makes total sense. I don't think you're lying at all. Do you know the dates that she worked? Like the starting and ending dates.
No, I couldn't tell you. That
so I guess you just know the years then. Which years was that?
Like I've known her for 12 years.
Oh yeah, but like what, you know, the actual working years.
I've had her do it
8 months total.
I could have had her do that. No, I could have had her do it more than that. I mean, so many times over the last 12 years.
Yeah, well, she says just 8 months, and she has two specific. Like what year was it that she worked for you during those 8 months?
Oh, I don't know.
You don't know? I mean, like, it's the year?
Was it last year?
It wasn't
very long ago the last time she worked with me.
Was it 2009? It sounds like you're a damn liar.
What the fuck?
ma'am? Hello? She's hung up on me. This is the best thing ever. I want to do these all the time now.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system. Come on.
Danielle?
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message.
She turned off her phone or something. Okay, here's puke again.
What am I going to do? I go and get another one. Now I got two. Ooh. Now I'm sitting here with your name on my skin. I can't believe I went and did this stupid shit again. My next girlfriend, now her name's gotta be Kim. Shit.
So why on earth would I need drugs when I'm flying kites, motherfucker? Slim Shady, Dr. Dre. I'm drunk past the test.
If I get locked up tonight, then I might not
come home tonight. Okay. I'm calling a lady who is putting her number out there for Mary Kay. She wants people to join Mary Kay. That's always a nice thing to do. Like, just constantly beg all your friends and family to join your pyramid scheme. Come on, Rhonda. Come
Hello,
on.
You have reached Rhonda Offelt, your independent beauty consultant with Mary Kay. I cannot get to the phone right now, so...
I'm an entrepreneur. My ex-wife did Mary Kay. She was retarded, too.
Hello.
Oh, hello. Is this Rhonda?
Yeah.
Oh, hi. I'm calling from Walmart. My name's Roy. I'm the general manager. I'm just calling to do a reference check for Robin Myers. She listed you as a reference check.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know Robin pretty well?
Yeah.
Okay. She says she worked for you for 9 months. Can you, like, is she a pretty good employee and everything?
Oh, yeah. I didn't have a...
I'm sorry? Hello?
Sorry about that. Sorry about that.
Oh, she's a pretty good employee then? Like, does she, what kind of work does she do for you?
Yeah, she showed up for work. I mean, I didn't have any problems with that. She was never late.
Oh, okay. What kind of work?
My dogs are trying to get me. Come on, guys.
Oh, yeah, way to change the subject. What kind of work did she do?
We was in direct sales.
Oh, yeah? Well, she says here that she did lawn landscaping and lawnmowers.
Uh-huh.
So it was landscaping?
My dog's trying to attack me. I'm sorry.
Oh, that's okay. Yeah, that's a good way to change the subject. And she says, so landscaping then?
Yeah.
And then she also says that you were her pimp and she was a hoe. How much did she make being a hoe for you? Hello, ma'am? Are you going to try and do the dog thing? She's gone. She just hung up. We got disconnected somehow. I'm going to call her back. I loved all the crashing sounds in the background. This prank has so much potential, this whole thing. Reference check idea.
Hello, you have reached Rhonda Offelt, your independent beauty consultant.
I thought people would be all confused when I said, you know, when their friends said that they worked for them, but they all are just willing to lie. They're like, oh, yeah, she worked for me. Maybe that's a really common thing for people to do. I know I do that for people. I tell people to sign me up and say that I worked for them, or they worked for me, or whatever.
Hello, you've reached Rhonda Offelt, your independent media consultant.
All right. All right. I'm going to find another one. Off and on, Dr. Trey is on. If I get locked up tonight, then I might not come home tonight. Keep it moving. Off and on, Eminem is on. Off and on, Dr. Trey is on. The whole entire world can sit and twirl like a whirling tire. I set a fucking girl on fire with a curling iron. It's like I'm just joking, for Christ's sakes. Don't get so bent out of shape, cause I went out and raped 6 girlfriends. Some people just don't get it, but I won't let it upset me, cause they don't know better. They don't know what the fuck it's like to be so fed up and fed. So many uppers, you're down, it won't get up. My mind's got a mind of its own. Sometimes I can't find it at home, it hides in the stove. Shit, talk about your brain being baked. My shit's still in the oven on 480 degrees. Haley Jade, daddy loves you, baby. You never tell me how to raise my daughter, fuck you, lady.
Hello.
Oh, hello. Is this John?
No, it's his grandmother.
Oh, okay. I was calling for John. Is John around?
Yeah, well, don't call this lady anymore.
Well, no, yeah, they told me this is the best time to reach him. I'm calling from Walmart. Ma'am? 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 Hello, ma'am? Ma'am, hello? Ma'am? Ma'am? Ma'am, hello? Hello? Ma'am? Oh, she hung up. Why'd she hang up? John lives with his grandmother. He looks like he's 30.
Hello.
Oh, hello. We got disconnected somehow. Is John around?
I said he's asleep. And they'll call you this late anymore.
Oh, no. No, you didn't tell me he was asleep before. I'm calling to do a reference check. I'm calling from Walmart. So it's okay.
Well, I didn't call you at 4 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, no, I didn't accuse you of that. This was the best time to call him. Is he around?
Is this for a job?
Yeah, well, it's a reference check.
Hold on.
He listed you as a reference check. Is this his grandmother, then? Hello? Ma'am? Ma'am? Hello? Ma'am? Ma'am?
Yeah.
Oh, he listed you as a reference check, so you're a reference check for John, then?
Yeah, but I never got a reference check at 5 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, he said this was the best time to reach you. Oh, so you worked...
Maybe it's 7:30 or 8 o'clock in the morning, but not 4:30.
I could call back. I mean, so...
Okay, what do you want to know?
Well, so he worked for you, then, for 2.5 years?
He worked for Griffin Elevator.
I'm sorry, what?
For Griffin Elevator.
Oh, no, it says on here on the application that you were his pimp and he was a hoe.
Fuck you.
What? That's not professional. What the hell was that? He's calling to do a reference check on John.
Hello.
Oh, hi. We got disconnected somehow.
Yeah, you call me one more time, and I'm fucking gonna call the police.
You want me to call you again, ma'am? Ma'am? Hello. Visualize individuals' lives through a criminal's eyes. The neighborhood that I grew up in, you could die for nothing. And Dirty Dozen watches over me, so try some dumb shit. I have a fucking man raped with a band-aid over his mouth and shove his head in a fan blade. You'll never tell me what I can or what I can't say or change because of the age range of my fan base. Like I give a fuck who's buying this shit. What fucking buying it? I'm tired, bitch, I'm dying to quit. Hip-hop is universal now, it's so commercial now. It's like a circus full of circus clowns up in the circuit now. But okay, I think it's time for me to quit. I'm gonna quit. Poor Cool Rob, you're just always wronged. You're always being kicked and wronged. Wronged in every way. That sucks for you, Cool Rob. I think we should kick everyone in the room. Everyone that has ops, I want you to kick everyone else that doesn't have ops. And we're gonna take care of this problem. God damn it. Cool Rob's gonna get justice tonight.
Yeah, it's late. I need to get to sleep because I'm tired. I've been taking sleeping medicine lately, and I'm trying to keep a normal schedule. And this is—it's not going to help if I stay up late doing prank calls. What else? Oh, let me try this Walgreens thing again. I can't take sleeping medicine tonight though, because I've had like 37 Four Locos now. That's like 500 beers. What? Did I get kicked? I got kicked. Did I get kicked? What happened? Damn it. Why am I kicked? Wait, I'm confused. What's going on?
I'm so scared. I can't come to the phone right now. Please leave your message.
If I got kicked, how did I come back? I'm so confused. I was kicked by horse machine. Fucking horse machine. God damn it. But nobody else is kicked. How come it's just me? God damn it. God damn bath salts. Yeah, I'm gonna give up on these photo customers. The end, you're crazy. Crazy, crazy. The end says he made me come back. The only other time that's ever happened with me is when I left Pound Madhouse when Death Fox had the server and he made me come back. And it was like magic. Because I left and I went to Pound HQ. Dick Soup says I should call the guy that said he was going to go to Walgreens. I tried that earlier, and he didn't pick up, so I just deleted his info. So I don't know his number anymore. Let me see if I can Control-Z a few times. And I'll find it. Oh, look! There it is! Yay, Control-Z! But when I tried earlier, it just rang, and he didn't pick up. So I think they're asleep. He says he's going to visit the store in the morning. The girl's name is Veronica. He wouldn't let me talk to her. Oh, did I get kicked again? Come on.
Hi, you reached me. We're unavailable. Please leave a message.
I don't remember hearing that voicemail before. That's weird. That was like a kid or something.
Hi, you've reached 986. Sorry, we're not in. Please leave your name and number, and we'll get back to you as soon as we can. Thank you.
Oh, God damn it. Did I just play... I'm never going to put the show up on the site, because it's going to take forever to edit, because I've let everything go out on the air tonight. It's going to take me hours to edit this shit. Okay, there's no area code, so that's good. I guess I'm not going to be able to get into that one. If anyone wants to call them, their phone number is 986. Call them up and give them a piece of your mind. Oops, I let that go out over the air. Stupid me. Stupid, stupid, stupid me. God damn it. More shit to edit. All right, thanks everyone for listening. It's been fun. Yeah. I'll have to do this again some other time, a week or two. What song should I play? This one. Okay, good night everyone. Thanks for listening. Goodbye. Sweet dreams. Baby, baby.
was I supposed to know? But something wasn't right here. Oh, baby, baby, I shouldn't have let you go. And now you're out of sight, yeah. Show me how you want it to be. Tell me, baby, 'cause I need to know now. Because my loneliness is killing me. Baby, baby.